Dear Lucy, is there an age limit for corseting? Well, I've received this question from girls as young as 12 years old and women as old as 70. And I had given them my answers in probably three or four previous videos now, but I never actually dedicated an entire video to it. And I think it deserved an entire video so people can easily search for it. Well, if there is an age limit for corseting, it depends on who you talk to. If you ask me, yes. If you ask some other people, no. So when I have these girls of 12 or 13 years old messaging me, they promise me they're going to go really slowly with their corseting, they're going to be super patient and responsible about it, I tell them the same thing. Waist training in particular is a form of body modification, the way that piercings and tattoos are forms of body modification. If you walk into a tattoo parlor, if they're respectable, they'll ask you for ID to make sure that you're over the age of 18, or in some cases, over the age of 16, and at least you have parental consent. So why 18? It's not this magical age where you're suddenly maturing your body. But in many countries, this is the age that you're considered a legal adult. Your parents are no longer responsible for your actions. You're responsible for yourself and your own well-being and your own choices. And that's why many places will refuse to work with anybody under the age of 18, because they're not responsible for their own bodies yet. And also consider the fact that many countries require you to be older than 18 to participate in certain harmful activities such as smoking and drinking. So to give you a really straight answer here, when somebody writes to me and asks me how old they have to be before I allow them to waist train, firstly, I'm a young woman on the internet. I can't give you permission. I can't make you waist train or not waist train. That's your prerogative at the end of the day. However, I tell those people the same thing that most tattoo parlors would say. You have to be at least over the age of 18 so you're responsible for your body, or you have to have parental consent. And admittedly, I did try my first corset at the age of 15. It was very light reduction, but I know that a lot of teenagers are probably watching this and saying, well, that's BS because I'm so mature for my age and I went through puberty at this age and I know that I've stopped growing in height, blah, 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 But unfortunately, it has nothing to do with the maturity level in your mind. It has nothing to do with when you first got your period or how long ago you stopped growing in height. It has to do with the fact that your skeleton is not totally mature yet. When you're first born, a lot of your skeleton is comprised of cartilage, not bone. And as you grow older, that bone slowly transitions from the cartilage into real bone until you're about the age of 25 or 30, which is the age that your skeleton is pretty much totally mature. So at the age when a lot of people are, say, 13, 14, 15, 16, they're starting to get interested in corseting, your skeleton is simply not mature. It has a lot of cartilage in there, which is softer than bone and weaker than bone. And if there is even just the slightest risk of somebody bending or cracking a rib because of waist training, because they were too young when they started, and I simply cannot condone that. Is it true that 200 years ago, little girls as young as 6 or 7 years old wore bodices? Yeah, actually, both girls and boys wore bodices, but that was to promote good posture and also somewhat to prevent the bruising when they're running around and to prevent deformity as a child is growing up. It's also true that today you can find kids 12 years old or even younger wearing back braces, say as a mode of therapy for correcting scoliosis or other forms of congenital spinal issues. And in those braces, yeah, you can get a significant amount of waist reduction in it because it's so tight around the waist and the hips. It's made to be that way to immobilize the spine, because that's what they need to do to be able to change the curvature of it. You can see that for people who had worn these types of braces for much of their younger lives, it has affected the shape of their ribcage. However, that's all under medical supervision, and you cannot guarantee that just an off-the-rack fashion corset is going to be as safe or as effective as, say, a back brace will be. You have to go to a specific corseteer who's experienced in working with those types of conditions. And on the subject of height, I thought I had completely finished growing by the time I was 13 or 14 years old, because I didn't seem to change in my height very much in high school. And then sometime in the first couple of years in university, I actually shot up another inch. I can prove that with my driver's license. And I know that there are exceptions to every rule. I know that there are people out there who have been waist training since they were, say, 13 years old, and they're completely fine today. I know people who have had their quality of life actually improved by wearing a corset when they were younger. And I think that's awesome, that's great, but I'm not touching it. I still can't condone it for the majority of tweens out there, and I am highly unlikely to change my stance on this. Now, if you're under 18 and you still really like the look of corsets, I mean, there are a ton of cheaper options out there that won't pull you in very much, maybe 1 or 2 inches at most, which is about the same that, say, a paired skinny jeans will pull you in, and you can still kind of get the look and the back support without having most of the risks involved with extended tight lacing or waist training. Now, on the other end of the spectrum, how old is too old to start waist training? Now, I'm a little apprehensive about setting a specific upper limit here because there are plenty of examples of women who started waist training or lacing when they were younger, say 20s, 30s, 40s, and they lived well into their 70s, 80s, 90s still wearing a corset. One living example today of a sort of mature woman wearing a corset is Kathy Young. She started wearing it when she was about 45 years old, and now she's about 75 years old, I think, and she is still lacing tight as ever. But granted, this was over 30 years of training. If somebody came to me now who's 75, 80 years old and wanted to start waist training at that age, honestly, I don't know what I'd be able to say. It really depends on the person, their health at the time, and their family history. So for any older women or men actually who want to start tight lacing or waist training, I would say you really have to take a look at your health. I would not recommend it for anybody who has osteoporosis or any kind of osteolytic autoimmune condition, because having more brittle bones increases your risk of cracking and fracture with a smaller amount of pressure being put on it. So even if the risk of cracking a rib on a healthy person is extremely small when you're wearing a corset, I don't know the exact number values of how much that risk would increase for somebody with osteoporosis. Also, for older women, you would have to take a look at whether you have any sort of vaginal or uterine prolapse, because while a corset is not likely to cause uterine prolapse, it can already exacerbate a pre-existing condition there because of the increased intra-abdominal pressure. And another thing that I mentioned in a previous video is watch out for hypertension and other circulation issues. So if you're elderly or overweight, then there is a higher risk of having high blood pressure. Also, depending on your activity levels, whether you smoke or not, what type of medications you're taking, you could also run into other circulation problems like thrombosis or numbness or anything like that. So you do have to be careful. And I know some people who are probably doing preliminary research on corsets right now, they're probably scared by what I'm saying, and they're saying, oh, a corset can cause all that, a corset can create all these conditions. Well, not necessarily. Usually it's a pre-existing condition that somebody has in their body, and wearing a corset simply amplifies the symptoms of it. But don't blame a corset for bringing out whatever problems you had in the first place. But you can see that there are so many different factors that go into a person's health that I can't definitively give somebody an answer on whether or not they can start corseting or not based simply on their age. I've seen people at the gym who are 65 years old and they look way healthier than some 20-year-olds, I know, but that's sort of besides the point. If you want to start wearing a corset, then make sure that your body is both healthy and prepared. That should be your motto, healthy and prepared. Prepared being that your body is fully grown and mature, and healthy meaning that there are no underlying conditions that will be exacerbated by wearing a corset. Now, there are certain health conditions that may be helped by wearing a corset. I know that some doctors recommend wearing a steel-boned corset to help correct hiatal hernia or diastasis recti, but you do need to check with your doctor in those cases. So I hope this cleared up a lot of people's questions, and I'd be very curious to know if you agree or disagree with anything that I said in this video. If you have certain experiences corseting either as a very young person or a very old person, I'm sure a lot of people would be curious to know, so please leave a comment down below or post a video response, and I'll see you in a few days with the next video. Bye!